Of my brother's souls, and should the sky be filled with fire and smoke, keep watching over Durin's sons. Yes, I am a nerd. And hello, everybody. Hello, hello, and welcome back to my stream. I am starting quite late today, and the stream will be much shorter today because I have stuff to do, basically. Excuse me. I had a very busy morning. I have not had a chance to eat at all. So I will be eating while I stream. I will try my best not to make too many loud chewing noises into the microphone. yeah. We're starting late, and it'll be shorter because of the same reason. Second, I need to adjust my volume a bit more. excuse me. Let's see here. Oh, wait. Helps if I'm actually looking at my stuff here. Announcements. Spookmas. This is my last stream of my usual types for the month. For a month, I mean. Starting next week, I will be going into... Hey, Yvonne. I will be going directly into spooky times through the month of October, starting with Resident Evil 7 on Monday. But today we are playing Shadow of War. It's been a while. It's been 2 weeks since we got into it because I couldn't last Thursday. Not last Thursday. It's the Thursday before last stream. And last week I was out because I was sick. So... Actually, I was sick because of, on both Thursdays. But anyway, couldn't stream, so we're jumping back in. And we're picking up where we were a couple weeks ago, so it's been a while. But, starting next Monday, we will, instead of Don't Look for Assassin's Creed, we will be starting Spooky Times for the month. Beyond that, check out my Linktree down below. You'll find a lot of the goodies in there. All right. Let's get into this shit.
Oh, misty eye of the mountain below.
How are you doing, Yvonne?
The remaining Gondorians live, but for how long? They are part of the resistance, and they will be made an example of.
Napping is important. You better take care of yourself. Alright. So, we were in Saragost, and we had completed Saragost. And we were getting ready to move on to Gorgoroth. Right? Nap well. All right, what do we got here? Hey deer, that's what we're looking for. We're looking for the hey deer. There we go. Let's go to that. There's Mount Doom in the distance. Yes, that's Mount Doom. Oh, I found a thing. I'm not gonna pick it up yet, but. Da 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 da. Not really. I mean, you ambushed me, so. Proof. And rages after he kills a beast. Okay. Excuse me.
Join the army of the Bright Lord.
I am your chosen.
Get the fuck out of here.
Whatever you say, boss.
All right, now where were we? Hey, dear. Right. There's the Barrows. Hey, Rose. Oh, no power. I see. Fair, fair, fair. Thanks for popping in. Stay alive. Excuse me. All right, that's everything. God damn, excuse me. I only took meds like right before I went live, so it'll be a bit before they kick in. Oh, there's the what's it called? The stadium E thing. Forget what it's called. I'm blanking. It's fine. Doesn't matter. Fire and smoke. Over. Da 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 da. Actually, hold on a second. I just remembered. Let me check. Nurnin, that's what it is. That's what it is. Ah. There's a worm over here. Let's grab the worm. This is what I do to call the— Hi, buddy. They're still building the one tower. That's one. All right, that's all of those. I've been watching the Rings of Power slowly and steadily. I'm not currently caught up, so no spoilers, please. But I've been watching it when I have time, and I am loving it. I kind of wish that they had gotten the guy who voiced Celebrimbor in this to play Celebrimbor, but I have no idea if he even looks like he could play an elf, you know? I just think it would be very interesting if they actually establish the events of this game as canon. Somehow. I'm not sure how they would, but it'd be interesting. Yeah. Don't worry about it. I'm not gonna be here long.
Chase him down.
Da 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 da. All right, give me a second. All right. All right. Three more artifacts and two Ithildim. One Ithildim. Two more artifacts. No more Ithildim. One more artifact. Oh, there we go. Skill point gained. What do we want to put it in? Consume increases wrath. Okay. Second. Come on, Discord, get your shit together. Okay. Sorry, Discord's arguing with me. All right. So, first things first.
A Ronk.
Ronk the greedy. Terrified of executions. Flammable and vulnerable to stealth. Well, sucks to be him then. Oh God. Okay. Oop, wrong button. Shit.
Who are we?
Who are you?
Oshgarn.
Arrowproof. But he's not stealthproof. Sucks to be you! Okay. Again, I apologize for all my coughing.
It is a fundamental truth of Mordor. The orcs have been here far longer than men. Far longer than the Dark Lord himself, even. This place belongs to them, and in their own way, the orcs revere their heritage. We found this sword in a crude shrine, after all. Yet imagine what the orcs and Mordor could become if freed of the Dark Lord's corruption.
The orcs can temper a blade, I'll give them that.
They produce weapons in mass, but they give little care to each one.
An intruder! Gonna crush you!
Second. Terrified and more guy flies. Easy. Nation comes from the sky. Da-da-da-da. Inside the mountain, I see fire.
See how quickly and quietly you can find yourself all alone.
Mm-hmm. Oops, that's not the button I meant to push. Oh well.
Well, that was quick. You need to take your time, the way I'm going to with you.
More guy flies, right? Right. Okay.
I'll miss you, Ranger.
Celebrimbor's invasion of Mordor was ultimately a civil war. Recall how he stoked the fires of fratricide by forcing orcs to kill other orcs. Alright, I'm opening a thing of cheese dip.
Sadras, here in Mordor, loyalty passes from orc to captain to overlord, and the chain of loyalty ends in a ring of power. Together we face doom.
God damn it.
Oh,
not him. No, not him. There's one combat hit. Domination. Cool. Hit him. Hit him. Hit him. God damn. There we go. There we go. There it is. And that's all three. Check. Check. And check. Mark.
Minas Ethel held many treasures far grander than this necklace, though none more precious to me. When I was a little girl, I would sneak into the Great Hall and take this necklace from its locked cabinet, thanks to a loose latch that only a child's hand could reach. For hours, I would admire myself in the mirror, imagining myself an elegant lady of Gondor, much like my mother must have been. My father caught me eventually, but as punishment, I received only a lecture. Perhaps he didn't mind seeing his daughter in such finery.
I'm surprised this necklace isn't hanging from some orc's neck.
Perhaps their stubby fingers cannot work such a delicate clasp.
Fair. A little racist, but fair. Honestly, I'm surprised they didn't melt it down and use it for something. That's more what I'm surprised about.
The Analects of Ruvenir is a collection of advice from a long-ago Gondorian citizen. It includes a series of exercises he guaranteed would lead to triumph in every duel. Like all young Gondorian soldiers, I studied the Analects a great deal, and I learned two key things. One, Ruvenir's swordsmanship was undoubtedly better than his penmanship. And two, in Ruvenir's time, duelists were far more courteous than the orcs of Mordor. War ignores such niceties.
Indeed.
A treatise on fine swordsmanship.
All too rare in these times. Such grace is lost on the denizens of Mordor.
Filled with fire and smoke, arching over the song I keep humming, if you don't know, if you can't recognize it, is Icy Fire by Ed Sheeran. Oh, hi. And the reason I keep humming it, or singing it, even, is because
man blood they infest, and once they're in, they lay their little eggs, and never again can anything be still. You will know their churning boil.
Aren't you one of mine?
Feel it! They swarm!
Now kill it! I swarm you.
Hush, Grish.
Why is he still showing up as blue? Oh, maybe he has to. Maybe because he's undercover or something. I don't know. Could also be glitched for all I know.
We know little of the Harrigan, mostly folk tales told around the campfire. The stories say they are fierce, pitiless warriors, as cruel as the orcs and as stern as the southern mountains beyond which they hail. Those folk tales convince many a Gondorian child to behave, but I cannot reconcile them with what I see in the only Harrigan I know, Baranor. He is fierce in battle and stern when needs must, but cruel? Never.
Anyway, as I was saying, I See Fire by Ed Sheeran. There's a cover.
Strange clothing.
And yet to the men of the south, it is as ordinary as your tunic. Only distance makes this precious.
By Jonathan Young that I've come across. That's fucking amazing. And if you haven't heard the I See Fire cover by Jonathan Young, you absolutely should check it out, because it is fire.
Sauron understood that power did not come from armies, but the willingness to sacrifice, to lie in wait. This is the truth he taught me, and so and when the day comes, I will make my sacrifice.
She sacrificed the ring. She gave it to us.
There is calculation in her every move. We can never trust her.
Watching over you. Okay. Now then. Mountainside. Oh, hi, spiders. Bitter spiders.
Oh God.
Let's find Baranor before it's too late.
He is bait, Talion, and he will live until we arrive.
Yeah, he's probably not wrong.
Men, the purpose of this camp is torture.
To come all the way to Lordborn's with this one. Punish my feet like this. Orders is orders. If he can lead us to more of these pigs, then it's worth it.
God. We must leave!
One more. There. Hello, sir. Let me help you out here.
An escape this place.
All right, Baranor. Oh shit, she's not doing well.
Suppose you're going to turn the camp upside down just so you can feel like you've done something. Truth is, it won't make a big enough difference.
Probably. It's not cool, guys. But I enjoy it, so.
Ranger! Look around. You failed them. You failed yourself. This is how your whole Mordor adventure will end.
Probably. But again. Can I free him? Can I just like cut him out?
Are you able to fight?
More than him.
Leave her alone, you prick.
You will join me.
Yeah, I will serve as your chosen.
Fuck out of here.
Yes, master.
You're injured.
It's nothing. You saved us. Again.
You were right. Staying in Mordor is so easy. But I cannot leave.
My lady. We will be doomed together.
Poor Gondor. Interesting. What's my current level? Oop, wrong one. 68. Okay, I don't have enough for that. Probably not enough for that either. That's okay. The knife was what was weakish. Inside the mountain, I see fire. Curious. Hold on a second. I need to check quests. Dirith Ungul is where again? Oh, right here. Okay. So I'm not there yet. Fighting pits, that's what they're called. I can't believe I blanked on that.
Balrog rises.
We have to go fight a Balrog, but I'm not ready to do that yet.
And we must send it back to the depths.
Why is it not? Hi, don't mind me. That's not what I wanted to do. A paragon of the Elven Art of War, Celebrimbor was as elusive as he was lethal. Honor the memory of his prowess by killing Uruks without being hit. This is gonna be a pain in the ass, isn't it?
Banias. Elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
Sorry, my mouse keeps catching on something. Okay. I'm gonna lure them over here. Hi, guys. Bite me. I got hit. Good to know that getting hit is an instant fail.
Banias.
Elves are the embodiment. Banias. Pain in the ass.
You were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
All right. Follow me, fuckers. Where is it? Here it is. Four, five, six. Damn it. I'm trying to be clever. Fire and smoke.
Banias. Elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
Hey guys, pick up. Oh, wow, I fucked that up. Okay, not me not paying attention.
This beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
Yeah, over here. Hi guys, follow me. Not touchy, but follow. Not touchy, yes, follow. Hi, fellas. Oh, God. How about you get... There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, maybe? Yes! Okay. Bye. There we go.
Sauron taught us a bitter lesson. Those in fair form.
I've never heard tales of these Balrogs.
Like the elves, Sauron values wisdom above all else. But for him, it is a cold, hard thing. He believes freedom is an empty virtue. He believes that Middle-earth seeks perfection in order. He believes that he will achieve what those before him could not.
Never thought I'd hear you say that.
If I
this is the end. I'll raise the beacon.
Raise the beacon all you fucking want. Ain't gonna touch shit.
Yeah.
is it? Oh, it's underground. Yeet. Not me jumping literally through a waterfall of lava. Fine.
There is a beauty in power. There is a beauty even in violence. But there is no beauty in tyranny. In the rule of one. That is why he must be stopped. I saw a battle upon a tower. I saw the Dark Lord defeated and a Bright Lord take his place. But the world did not change. I repeat.
The world did not change under the Bright Lord.
She turned away from Sauron, as did I. And yet she cannot see that.
She fears you. She fears what will become of Middle-earth when we defeat him.
I do not fear the orcs. But in the deep of night, I will admit this. I fear their drums. An orc can be defeated in battle. His threat can be walled off or outmaneuvered. But the low rumbling of the drums, that cannot be halted by any artifice of man. Those drums are the heartbeat of their factories, and every beat marks the orcs' relentless advance. We seized these drums in a raid, and I locked them up in the Great Hall so that no orc could ever play them again.
Give me just a second. Okay.
So the orcs have musicians among them.
Hardly. Uruks are made for warfare, not artistry.
Down here.
It has long been customary for the people of Minas Ithil to offer an amphora of water or wine to any visitor from beyond our walls. Such travelers were rare, especially recently, and making the trek to the frontier almost guaranteed a thirsty guest. But when our need was greatest, no one from Gondor came to our gates, thirsty or otherwise.
This amphora, it is older than it appears.
Just as well we reclaimed it then. The orcs would sully it with their grog.
Look!
Vision comes before the scan.
There are no dwarves in Mordor. At first glance, this land would seem to suit them. Plenty of stone for carving and ore veins to mine. This shield belonged to a dwarf from another age who did come to Mordor, though not as a craftsman nor a miner. Now that Minas Ithil no longer contains the orcs within Mordor, the dwarves will have to put down chisel and hammer and pick up their shields once more.
Sorry, give me just a minute. Throwing away some trash, and I need to refill my cup. Button. There we go.
A dwarven shield? But where are the dwarves?
Deep underground, coveting their treasure, no doubt.
These?
Fortress is a house of pain.
It will still fall.
Things lost forever.
Is that all she said? Some things are just lost forever?
But some things were lost forever. But some things were lost forever.
Interesting. Give me a second. Is that a Numenorean device? They were not ungenerous with their skill, teaching the men of Middle-earth much of their arts and crafts. Some artifacts from their time baffle us to this day, their construction and purpose far beyond our ken. Yet, if we scratch the surface of any farmer's field, we find devices like this, proof that their grand civilization once dominated Middle-earth. Interesting.
What did this device do?
Probably nothing. The Numenoreans experimented too much and perfected too little.
No need to be a dick about it, Celebrimbor. He didn't stab me in the first place.
This statement of stewardship reads like a mundane description of lawmaking, but it is one of our most treasured documents. Gondor is a realm of law, not of kingly pronouncements. Since the disappearance of Eärnir, our last king, Gondor has thrived under the guidance of ruling stewards, each a lord of Minas Tirith. The steward's office is hereditary, and its decrees are law, unless a king someday returns to Gondor's vacant throne. And even then, I'm not sure what use we'd have for a monarch, save to keep the cushion on the throne warm.
Poor Aragorn. Come on.
Freed Gondor from its kings.
And yet the steward rules from a throne room, does he not? It's scarcely different.
Yep. I've always felt the same way, Celebrimbor. My dragon still up in the eye? In the eye. In the sky? English. Alright. Character. Bye. By the mountain, I see. Oh, I see fire. High quality gear drops from captains or higher ranking orcs. Use domination speed. Quality gems. I'm good with that. I'm good on gems, believe it or not. Honestly, no, I think I'm good on discerning eye, honestly. Alright, let's see what we got. Those are all completed. Those are all completed except for that one. That's all completed except for that one. That's all except for that's all except for that one. A mountain. Excuse me. Oh, wrong way. All right. They stalk and blank, then lash out so furious. Yet our bulwark is proof against their rage. Our hard-ringed, hand-forged armor, impervious to the predations from the hours of darkness, no matter how vicious or how vile, to assail the Bright Lord is to falter and fail.
They stalk and lurk, then lash out so furious. Yet our bulwark is proof against their rage. Our hard-ringed, hand-forged armor impervious to predations from the powers of darkness, no matter how vicious or how vile. To assail the Bright Lord is to falter and fail.
All right. Ooh. Interessante. Okay. All righty. 452. I have a decent bit of grinding to do. And but I have a month to do it, so you know, I won't be prioritizing it too much. When Celebrimbor marched into Mordor, the entire realm went to war with itself. Remember how he flew into battle atop a drake, killing the mighty growls of his enemies.
In the Second Age, we honored Tirith, the virtue of vigilance. We watched our enemies closely, only to be deceived by Sauron in the guise of a friend.
Damn it.
In the Second Age, we honored Tirith, the virtue of vigilance. We watched our enemies closely, only to be deceived by Sauron in the guise of a friend.
There we go. Check. Check. Check.
True vigilance means watching friend and foe alike. Especially in Mordor, ally can become enemy in a heartbeat.
Ally can become enemy in a heartbeat. Alright. Hold on. Do I have the ground drain ability? I must. Where would it be? There it is.
One of my ancient war chiefs, the Iron Mount, understood Caragors on an instinctive level. In truth, he was more bestial even than the other Uruks. And every beast can do work, if given the right harness.
Give me a quick second before I do this. Ah, hello, Melador. Welcome, welcome. Good to see you. Oh, you've redeemed the Ara Ara. I see. Ara Ara. How are you doing? Okay. I'm actually going to be wrapping up here in a minute because I got some stuff I need to do before you and I do some shit later, you know? Is that a ground execution that it wants? Yes. Jump into the pool of lava. Grisha Iron Mount.
Those were Mordor's finest caragos, bred and trained for hunting and war. Whoever set those caragos free will surely be their next meal.
Now I have to dominate him. Ground dominate. Now remind me, game, what is ground dominate? Knock him down and then drain him. Okay. He's soft-headed, so he becomes dazed when he's shot in the head. Fireproof and beast-proof. Enraged by weakness. Okay. Oh shit, he's got two captains with him. Okay. Hey Matt, what are you currently got going on? Time to get some space. All right, hold on. Let's actually character. Got a GTFO real fucking quick. Hi, you. You're mine now. Come on, fall over. Damn it. Fine, I'm just gonna get this guy. Get the fuck out of here.
But I was just getting started.
Okay, he's enraged. Fine. Oh, God, that's the wrong place. Hold on a second. Let me. Shit, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? I think I just unlocked. There it is. Thank you. Shit, I don't have arrows. Oh god, dude hit me in woohoo, okay. Let's let this guy calm down. He did. Okay. They're coming after me still. All right. Okay, he's coming, he's coming, he's coming, he's coming. Inside the mountain, I see fire. Running and soaring, I see fire. Don't kill yourself on your way down. Okay. Please tell me I just did the thing.
Your will be done.
Check. Check. Yeah!
Yes, master!
The Iron Mount was more beast than Uruk. But a beast is what I needed for a savage war against Sauron. As one of my war chiefs, the Iron Mount had instincts that fell in line with my refined strategies.
My refined strategies. I love how much he compliments himself. All right. Okay. Night. Now let's take a look at the map. See, we only have this thing. Thank you. Alrighty. So that's it from me for a while. Well, the Balrog rises for the week, actually.
And we must send it back to the
back depths. To its depths. Yes, 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 yes. And we shall, just not immediately, not imminently. Yeah, that's it from me for the week. And reminder that starting next week is October, and so that means that we will be starting our Spookmas streams. Spookmas! Woo! Yeah! This year will be much more fluid than last year. My times will vary. Basically, I'll be streaming when I feel like it. It'll still be afternoon and evening of the weekdays. But my goal is to stream every day. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and Friday. But stream times are fluid. So I might, some days I might stream later, other days I might stream earlier, etc. And on days other than when I'm playing games with Matt, like Phasmophobia or Forewarned or something like that, I will be starting one game and focusing on it until it's completed, and then moving on to the next game. Basically, I was feeling a little bit overwhelmed last year with the way I was doing things. So, you know, this is to keep it a bit easier on me. So yeah, starting on Monday, Resident Evil 7. I haven't played it before. It will be my first time playing it. The only Resident Evil experiences I have playing Resident Evil, because I've seen the shows and some of the movies and some of the shows. But the only experience playing the games myself that I have are Resident Evil 2 Remake and 3 Remake. So this will be interesting. I know that you're I know a bit about the lore, because I've seen some playthroughs, not complete playthroughs, but some playthroughs. I know that you play as a guy named Ethan Winters, and it has to do with his wife. There's some weird stuff that goes on down south, basically. So I'm looking forward to that. Yeah. If you want to rewatch any of my streams, this one or any of my others that I've done up until this point, feel free to check out my Linktree at the bottom of the screen. There you will find a link to my YouTube, which has all of the VODs of not every stream, but the majority of my streams, available. It's got my Lord of the Rings streams, it's got Watch Dogs, it's got Mirror's Edge, it's got Tomb Raider, and it's got Assassin's Creed. All of each of those that I've streamed so far. It's also got last year's Spookmas stream, so if you want to watch me stream Spookmas games last year, you can absolutely do that. Watch me on my YouTube. Alternatively, you could subscribe to me on here and check the VODs out as well, because they're here as well. Also in my Linktree, you'll find links to my social medias where you can follow me for updates on stream times and announcements and things like that. Or you could join my Discord, where you can hang out with me and get updates, etc., etc., etc. Also, you should check out these people up here at the top. They are friends of mine who I think you should follow and or show love for. I have even more suggestions like them and others in the Linktree down below. Beyond that, remember to have empathy, be kind, be safe, love yourself, and love everyone around you, and I will see you all on Monday. for them creepy times. If the creepiest times are not for you, if the creepy times are not for you, that's okay. You don't have to hang out. You can, and then I'll see you at the end of the month. So yeah, if the creepy times aren't for you, that's perfectly okay, and I'll see you next month after the spookmas. But yeah, I'll see you all next time. I love you all. Peace out.